China against China. Doubles partners against each other. Former world champions in that regard as well. Wang here to begin this one. Serving first.
Different styles, both. Definitely, of course, forehand dominant players. I'd say Wang Chuqin has the stronger backhand of the two and the stronger flick. Forehand wise, though, there's nothing between them. Angle's important against Ma Long. Someone who can move so well around the court, even at the age of 33, which is typically older than you see a player playing for the Chinese men's team. An Olympic champion. Only player to do it twice. No sign of slowing down, you know, the way he is, you know, it's like the equivalent of sort of Cristiano Ronaldo in football, just able to maintain this level for so long.
Easily just through with the arm there. And a lot of interest around this, of course, just looking around the hall. You'd expect it was similar for Ma Long. You mentioned that point about still being around because, you know, there's always that suggestion. I mean, when you're watching him, the greatest of all time, that could be one of the last times that you watch him. It's the... When he produces points like that here with Wang Chuqin, you just say, keep going on and on. What's the point early on here?
I mean, you know, if Wang Chuqin was a right-handed player, it'd be almost impossible to play as a left-hander. He's that much more awkward, but Ma Long, just effective against anyone. Forehand is a thing of beauty, isn't it? Poetry in motion. Even in slow motion, actually, it looks quick. Bigger stroke than Ma Long's forehand, which means he has a little bit less recovery time, but yeah, he does recover so well. Have to do in doubles, which he's proven himself so well in the mixed and men's as world champion. Well, the receive sat up and Ma Long couldn't put it away uncharacteristically, but it was short on the table, it wasn't long. Ma Long doesn't miss long high balls, but shallow high balls he can miss. Forced to come over the table more. 5-4. Usually Wang Chuqin either blocks or counters, but I've seen him punch a couple of times actually. He doesn't usually do, but Charles Morikawa, we see doing that a lot.
Said it all there. Oh, Long pushing long, well long. Lead now for Wang is at 3 here. Absolutely clutch serving, wasn't he, against Lin Gaoyuan for the most part last night. Needs some of that again here. Is it trail 8-5 in the deciding fifth game against the Dark Knight? Change it up there, go fast and long, but Wang was alive to it.
Good serve from Ma Wang. It was into the middle area of Wang Chuqin. You can see it here. Bottle challenge kind of serve. Made the space though, didn't he? High racket finish above the head there. Different kind of technique, different kind of silhouette Wang Chuqin to a lot of Chinese players. He usually finished the racket in front of the head. He finishes it above it sometimes.
8-5. This is there again on in the table there. That short forehand. Not for the first time in this opening game, Ma Long.
Just so interesting seeing these two face off, because it's a player who has proved himself on every major occasion since 2015. Up against a 22-year-old Wang Chuqin who has everything to prove.
Punch off the tape and long, and errors from the greatest of all time contribute in the end to him dropping the opening game of this one to Wang Chuqin.
The better start of this semi-final, 11 points to 5.
And this clash of generations, it's the youngster striking first, 11-5.
Malong anyway, starting the round of 32 in the men's singles against Félix Lebrun, the wonder teenager of France, 3-1. Then against Marcos Freitas from Portugal, 3-0. Against Copetti of Nathan Yuan, 3-2. And routes to the semi-final.
Beginning here, and Ma Long with a bit of work to do. He's got longer, of course, to get into it here. Best of 7 now. Master of that situation. We talk about his biggest titles. Well, they're over that distance. In the modern game, it's really the king distance, isn't it? That best of 7, it decides the big titles. No different here in Budapest this week. These world table tennis stops, everyone wants to win them, and fittingly at the back end, it's best of 7. Oh. He handled that, Ma Long, so well, because that was awkward.
As an example of where the net doesn't help you. Bounced high, but he ran in well and just got the angle. They're the kind of rallies that we expect to see from Ma Long and that will prove successful for him. Ma Long doesn't want an open rally against Wang Chuqin. Wang Chuqin, and this is a kind of head on the chopping block statement, but I believe he's more powerful than Ma Long in the rally. Ma Long's more powerful overall, because his powers don't come in big shot ways necessarily. He can suffocate you with touch shots. Touch play, it's a great change of tactics.
It's a great point you make, Fraser, because you just look here, that forehand is actually more compact than Wang Chuqin's.
Yeah.
And it's almost like, I think sometimes with Ma Long, that you know, he's not trying to always win the point outright with the forehand. He does, because it's such a good shot. But he's ready to play another one.
Exactly. Exactly. It's setting up the next. Wang Chuqin's is more of a point ender. And he, of course, has to expect it back and recover in case it does. He's playing a great retriever. People don't think as Marlon as a great retriever. Doesn't need to be most of the time, but he is. One of the best in staying in the points when he's on the back foot. He doesn't lob Marlon, he fishes, which gives his opponent less time than a lob, even when he's stepping back away from the table. He's a genius. Well, it's just as fluid as a glass of water right now. He's smooth, relaxed. See him just rolling the shoulders over just to stay loose. Moving well, and I mean, I can't remember ever seeing Wang Chi-Chin get 11-0'd. Could it happen? Can you imagine?
It's a possibility now, that ongoing debate, should he take another point about the mercy point, whether it can be offered up, or whether you offer no mercy and go on and register the donut, the 11-0.
No way, I can't believe this. I cannot believe what we are seeing.
Well, no mercy being shown there for sure.
What will happen now? Might be different mentality against a teammate than against someone outside the team. Well, he does.
Yep. That's there. So the donut avoided.
I can't believe it.
That will do. Roared out, of course, to that 10-0 advantage. And on the third game point, Marlon levels this semi-final up. One apiece. Amazing run of points, that. 10 in a row. And 11-2 in the end.
He's up against a player, Marlon, who knows so well. But still, Wang Chi-Chin, the highest level young player of all time, and the level does get higher every generation that comes along. This is a player, you know, Wang Chi-Chin, that has never lost to Beauregard in a best of seven, never lost to Promoto in a best of seven, never lost to Lin Wenru apart from one time, you know? And Ma Long's just gone 10-0 upon him. How? I know it's Ma Long, but how? Tactical change. Not flicking there, knowing that Wang Chi-Chin's waiting for the counter. Touching short, waiting for the long ball. Every point he played perfectly. 10 out of 10 for Marlon. Could have even been 11 if he hadn't have given it away. Hard to tell, actually, whether he did it on purpose. And I think that was intentional from Marlon. Out of respect for his doubles partner and younger teammate. Perfection from the dragon. Will that be a massive dint in the confidence of Wang Chi-Chin, who tends to always have his head held high when he plays? Or will it be...
Oh, it's just there and waiting.
Marlon knows that so much pace is going to come in off this flick, so he just puts his bat there. That's all he needed to do.
It's been incredible, this, because he won 10 points in a row. Went 10-0 up in the previous game, Marlon. 13 of the last 16 now. He enjoys this, doesn't he? I mean, when he drops the opening game there, Fraser, 11-5, you know, you look at his run through this week at the Star Contender as well. This is interesting. When he played Felix Lebrun in the first round, lost the opening game there. And then he produces that. It's fitting of the greatest of all time, isn't it? It's just a point that he produces in his sleep.
The transfer
so easy.
Of weight, oh. You know. Getting flashbacks with that forehand from the 2015 World Championships against Fang Bo.
Yeah, and Suzhou. You don't have to go back 7 years, Fraser. There have been moments as well where he's just inflicting pain and more of it on opponents here. Another run.
Like you say, that match against Felix Lebrun, which was for me the most interesting match so far of this competition. Drops the first game, doesn't drop another.
Yeah. that away as well. And even as they go to the tail break, you look at last night, you look at the quarters as well against Lin Gaoyuan, mentioned it earlier, down, been leading through that match, 8-5 down in the fifth. He enjoys, and I think this is the thing, enjoys the challenges above all. You know, you were saying, okay, 33, you won everything. Considered the greatest of all time, but he enjoys the challenge, whether it's a 15-year-old pen holder or it's a fellow Chinese national team member. He's always getting the better of them.
Shows how much he respects his opponents, you know? And when you see some players who are nowhere near the level of Ma Long but have more arrogance, Ma Long, you have to be mega humble to reach that level, because you have to be, you know, conscious that you aren't good enough to where you want to be yet. Constant willingness to improve, even when you're already at this level. Ma Long's still striving to get better, and he's achieved more than anyone else has. Chin failing to find his feet.
This is a clever little receive, isn't it, though? It looked like it was popping up, but actually there was quite a lot of work on that ball.
There was. I mean, he did well to keep it tight because it was topspin, but it wasn't a great receive from Ma Long, to be honest. He did get away with it. Wang Chuqin should be putting those balls away, hence the disappointment on his face. I think that last game has really affected Wang. Really, really affected him. Because not only did he go 10-0 down in the last game, but he went 6-0 down the next, this game.
Find some way here, the 22-year-old, of drawing a line under that.
Ma Long's more conscious now than he was in the first game. Everything, whether it's a touch, whether it's a spin and placement on the serve, whether it's a push into a particular position, there's more intention behind every move, whether it be passive or aggressive. And that's why Wang Chuqin seems to be making more errors that are unforced when they're not. That's just the dragon doing what he does best, dictating.
That's another one. It's just pressure building and building on Wang Chuqin here. 7 game points. Aces him. Sweet there, straight through. Underlines the point. He's lost 6 points in the last two games here, Ma Long. This is devastating, even by his standards. Wang Chuqin is going to need to find a way of resetting here. He's being dusted up at the moment, the last couple of games, by the GOAT.
Igazán lényeg közül volt, amit Ma Long produkált az elmúlt két játszában, azokat elvesztette az elsőt viszonylag simán, a másodikban és a harmadikban összesen 6 pontot engedélyezett ellenfelének. Aztán 2-1-re vezet, hangsúlyozom, a 4 nyert szettig tartó mérkőzésen.
The audience here is a little bit stunned, especially those who follow the sport here at the moment. We had 11-5 for Wang Chuqin in the opening game here. But the last couple, those streaks that have been put together by Ma Long against someone of the calibre of Wang Chuqin, that is a bit astounding. 10 points in a row in the second, 6 in the third. It's going to be very interesting here mentally. Wang Chuqin, his many qualities is that he is just so mentally solid out there at the table. He's going to need all of that here. 2-1 down to Ma Long. Fortunate beginning. He'll take all of that at the moment.
Talked about the passing of the baton. Is it too soon? Too much to ask too soon from Wang Chuqin? Shot topspin serve into the forehand. And Ma Long flicks, typically less than a lot of players. He likes to come round and play the forehand push or touch. So with a short topspin serve, that can jam up Ma Long on the receive. Good change from Wang Chuqin. That's how he's going to get in that big third ball kill with a forehand. Oh, that is just a joke. Drifter serve, half long wide into Wang Chuqin's forehand, who feels the need to pick it up. Ma Long steps and knows what's coming. And look at that. Just incredible technique. Can I borrow that shot just for a day, Ma Long?
Oh, yeah. Wang here responds. Finisher of a forehand with a couple of goes.
Opening the racket face, adding a bit of side spin just in case Ma Long even tried to go for it. Sends the ball even wider out wide. No chance for Ma Long against that level of power. Just the edge. Wang Chuqin had one in the opening points, I can't complain. I'm not sure, a few times Ma Long. Long float into backhand, but that one was backspin actually, so Wang Chuqin had to lift it up. Ma Long must have fancied the counter once more, but didn't connect. That is a beautifully intricate touch game there. Because he thought that third one was coming long to attack. Ended up being too short, but still managing coming into the table, not even already there, able to keep it tight.
Another edge. Push this time, kissing the back edge of the table. These are the margins, of course, the fractions that decide this sport at the elite level.
Well, the placement was good, but he did misread how much topspin was on it, so Marlon lucky there, obviously. Wang Chuqin still going for that short topspin. hook serve.
Timeout is calling. Of course, no coaches around here, all Chinese affairs. So Wang Jiqin has seen his lead wiped out in this fourth game. He's decided to use his timeout here. Wants a moment to himself. Look at the head-to-head here, which we've touched on. It's, of course, two apiece. Everything points to a really tight contest here. Of course, difference in the ranking and general experience, of course, the years. But indeed, you can actually extend that head-to-head as well, their previous matches, because they've met at a couple of our exhibitions that we've had in World Table Tennis, and they've split those as well. But in terms of titles and everything else as well, of course, Ma Long well ahead in that regard. Why we do build this as the clash of generations, and if Wang Jiqin could win it, possible changing of the guard question again here. He can register a big win at an event like this, a star contender event.
Just thinking there at the break how Ma Long managing to fend off every young player coming up where that question's asked. I mean, Ma Long dominated, and I mean dominated, the head-to-head between himself and Fan Zhendong, who was winning the German Open at 16 years of age, beating Ovcharov, Samsonov. You know, it was Ma Long at one and Fan Zhendong at number two, and they were meeting in almost every final, and each time Ma Long won. And he still did it at the Olympics when Fan Zhendong was at world number one. Top block returned. Wang Jiqin forced back. And Ma Long misses the easiest ball of that rally. Quite odd. Wang Jiqin won't be complaining coming out of the timeout there. Has the serves. Ma Long, what he's doing is, that's a topspin serve of Wang Jiqin. So Ma Long can only push it if he comes around the side of the ball. Can't come under that or it's going to pop way long. So to come around the side is how he pushes it. With the dragon, the baby dragon.
Are you going to bill him as that?
Oh, we'll see. And you've got players like Lin Winru and Hamamoto, Zhang Peng, everyone around and about, Trolls as well, of course. It's almost impossible to predict to who will be the next Grand Slam champion. Fan Zhendong will take it if he wins at Paris. That's if he even plays. A lot can change in a couple of seasons.
Receive of decent quality there, and Ma Long, his turn to look towards the crowds.
Unplayable, that flick. It's as powerful as an intermediate player's drive, and it's just coming off a short serve. I mean, come on. Ma Long serves it with more no spin that time, more flow, and a little bit wider into the forehand, knowing that Wang Jiqin's confident, so he's actually there. Playing so much to the strength of Wang Jiqin, but putting it wider that it baits him.
Yeah, I was about to say, teasing his younger compatriot into the error. 9-8 here in the fourth. And that's a good follow-up from Wang. Set up the game point.
Spins the first one, gets the high ball, has the racket up, comes through the second. takes it really, really early there, not allowing the dragon any breathing room or time.
Oh, strong finish and a little pump of the fist there from Wang Chuqin. He's back in business in this semi-final. Levels it up, takes the fourth. 11 points to 9 here in Budapest. Two each now.
Wang is actually a three-time world champion. The team event,
that's really impressive from Wang Chuqin, especially after what had happened the previous couple of games where he had won 6 points across them. Able to, as mentioned, to reset. He's right back into this now. This stage, for all that Ma Long brushed him aside for a couple of games, it's 2-2 now in the best of 7.
Swings and roundabouts, really. It can actually be quite hard for a player who wins the game so comfortably to then mentally recuperate. But you can't expect it to happen again and again and again, especially against Wang Chuqin. You've got to expect him to fight back, so in a way it can put you kind of almost nervous as to what's to come.
So popular, of course, has his own fan club, they all do. The Chinese national team. Yes, Ma Long's is the biggest fan club of all.
I'd imagine, although I know the girls love Zhang Zhika. Although he's not playing, of course, anymore. But yeah, I'd imagine Ma Long's is the biggest right now, definitely.
Oh, what an opening to this game from the great man.
Spins the first one. And in the corner of his eye, I can see Wang Chuqin stepping round. To play that kind of shot we see Yukiya Uda doing really well. Oh, unplayable. That power coming over. It's so quiet, the feet of Ma Long are so quiet, but the shot's so fast, so it's really more of a speed shot. There's a swiftness to it. Hard to define the difference between speed and power, really. Perhaps power is the ability of how you use the speed.
Oh, the get, actually more than his initial attack, was amazing. The recovery from Ma Long here.
They both had to recover a really difficult ball there. Wang Chuqin from the middle and then Ma Long, exactly the same. It was played right down the middle line.
Just wondering there, though, back on your earlier point, whether Wang Chuqin in that same position might have been able to recover it as Ma Long did. Point about the forehand being so compact. Just gives him a chance, albeit it was still outstanding. Still had so much to do. First towel break and it's a run of sorts, isn't it? 5 of the first 6 points. That's what's been about Ma Long at his best in this match when he's put those runs together. Another one developing here.
Chuqin definitely needs to change something. Dragon's becoming very accustomed to proceedings. If I was Wang Chuqin, I'd maybe try and touch a few shots at the forehand of Ma Long. Get him close to the table, surprise him, and then try and send him out long. interesting backhand from Marlon. Not a full extension in the backhand there. Just kind of lifted it over. Try and slow things down. He's so good at making things slow as well as quick, Marlon. Change of pace, sublime. Seen a few of those, haven't we? Seem high enough to attack, but they're short.
I think, Fraser, it's, you know, we've had Sharath Kamalashanta on. I think it's this table is playing, how it's coming through the arena. Oh, just holds. I mean, they're both well used to, you know, handling that now. They've played a few matches on it, but I think it's maybe explaining sometimes why Wang Chuqin is not... I mean, the ball just not coming through as he's expecting.
Perhaps, perhaps.
Nothing he can do about that, of course. The lead is six. Familiar to us from the games two and three.
Games that won't have all been so comfortable. Marlon's also very conscious of the distance that he needs to play from the back of the white line. Doesn't want to stay too close, otherwise then he can't make space and have enough time to play his big forehands. Set, 3-9. Marlon's been a lot better in the touch play department between these two.
3-10. Taking care of business again here. And he's looking at a deficit again. 7 game points. 11-3. And he only needs the one. He's clinical there. And he's a game away now from yet another final. 3-2 up here. Marlon on Wang Chuqin.
From the final in the man singles. Hasonló volt a második és harmadik szethez, simán hozta Malong, ezúttal 11-3 arányban.
Marlon then moving back in front. Just joining us, Wang Chuqin taking the opening game, but Marlon breezing through the next two before Wang recovered. Edged the fourth, and now back to one-sided game there, 11-3. Marlon currently sitting at number two, of course, in the world rankings. Fan Zhendong, the winner of the Singapore Smash. He's lead at that point, of course, with all the points on offer at the Smash, which is really at the top in terms of the world table tennis pyramid. And Troels Morgaard, of course, there at five, and will be going up. The Swede awaiting through in the final. Morgaard will be up to four, and if he wins the title, will be up to three, the Swede. Be pushing Marlon in the rankings there. Interesting, isn't it, with Marlon? He's been asked about it here in Budapest. We all know he won the World Championship here 3 years ago. Also won one of his 45 other career titles here. Hungarian Open 2012. He loves this city. Spoken about it. It's funny when you come back to places, what can happen when you've had good memories? And he's got a lot of places that he has good memories, to be fair.
That's very true.
It's not just Budapest, but
40 odd career titles.
It's something when you have been somewhere before, and obviously winning here 3 years ago was massive, to be able to win that third world title at that time. When you come back, you're just feeling good.
It's interesting as well, isn't it? Because last time he was in a major final here was the World Championship final, and it was against the Swede. It'll be the same tomorrow if he gets through.
Yeah, Wang Chuqin, though, has got other ideas here. Let's not for 1 second here write off Wang at this stage. Strong start to the sixth. Fight!
Start that he needed Wang Chuqin. Fabulous over the table with the forehand so far. Flick's been more deadly, venomous, more zip behind it.
Sent so far back, he's almost out of our picture there, Wang Chuqin. Back of court here, pushed back.
Haven't seen a chop block yet from Wang Chuqin. Interesting how it's evolved from the likes of Voldner and Marlin to Kokiniwa and Trills.
That away so easily. Coming back into this sixth game, Marlon.
Affords a bit of dwell time on the backhand. Starts to stroke under his left armpit. The forehand, everything happens in front of the body. One was clean, second one hit the top edge of the racket. Happens quite a lot at this level because you don't want to hit the shot from the middle of the rubber. You want it to be near the edge because it produces more spin. It's the same with serving. You produce less spin if you contact the ball in the middle of the bat. You want it to be towards the edges.
Side, not edge. Safe, Fraser. Little bit concerning this for Wang Chuqin. I mean, he's done really well to keep that alive. That's not missed by much, but he's being pushed and pulled, isn't he, around the table now? I know he's got the lead in this sixth, but these points are increasingly being played away from the table at the moment. You'd say Marlon's getting the edge there at the moment. Errors, though, that are undermining him.
It's uncharacteristic to see a long push from Marlon. I mean, it wasn't that long. It was half long, but longer than the normal Marlon half long. I don't know how many times I've just said long in the last few seconds there. But yeah, Wang Chuqin's getting in first because he's been allowed to. And Marlon dominated the touch play start. It'd be interesting to see it now. Wang Chuqin is flicking more often, though.
Oh. Deepest push possible there. The high toss there. Marlon, just to give Wang something else to think about.
Tends to do it when he's losing, Marlon. It's almost like he's trying to add the distraction factor. Your opponent ends up watching the flight of the ball of the serve rather than the contact. It puts you off a little bit, a high toss serve. get it through on the final one. Much better receive though there from Mancic. That's the calibre of play he needs here.
Doesn't have to play a third ball there. 5 game points for Wang. Take this to a decider. Again, the first game point converted. Wang hits back again. And this old Chinese affair in Budapest is going to a decider.
And this great semi-final goes to an all-deciding 7th game. Kiegyenlített Rang Chuqin, 3-3, ennél szorosabb és izgalmasabb nem is lehetne ez a férfi egyes elődöntő. Még mindig nem tudjuk, hogy ki lesz Truls Veregol, a fiatal svéd fiú ellenfele. Jön a mindent elődöntő 7. szett.
On their previous matches, we have had some distance encounters between them. That was the word around, really. I mean, just kind of got a straw poll of that in a sense of which way this had come out. I think the common thought was that it's 4-3 either way, because I think based on the fact that they know each other, of course, know each other's games so well, that you're going to get those backs and forths. That's what we've had. Always, as always, Fraser in a 7th here. Who can make the strong start? Who can string it together for a few points when it really counts?
Well, Marlon tested so much by the Dark Knight. Had to come back from a losing position in the decider. He will not want to be in the same position here against Wang Chuqin. Wang was sent to the decider by Hugo. So both players know in this main draw what it's like to fight in the decider, and both will do so. And that's just murderous. Thousands of balls practiced against a heavy multi-ball feed. Just makes that ball look like it was nothing. And that was a heavy, heavy topspin from Wang Chuqin. Look at this. That's a good spin-up. But that's just perfect. Interesting how Marlon's also going for the high toss serve now at the start of the game. He usually just goes for it when he's trying to come back.
Oh! Fabulous.
Smooth as a Rolls Royce. But we have all the suspense right now. Of it being in the 7th game and playing freely like it was a training drill shows how accustomed he is to this level of pressure, if he even feels it. Doesn't seem like he does sometimes, but big chole here from Wang Chuqin. Marlon serving along, wanting the attack and stepping round. Wang Chuqin can spot that earlier. He can maybe try and go down the line to wrong foot Marlon. Has the serves now.
Take it for granted. I know they're only ending a little bit sooner than this crowd would have liked, but so much good in it prior to that. You do As I say, I have to say, with world table tennis, because of the quality we get basically every event, you just kind of, you think, okay, is it really that good? That was good, so good. Got to relish this. In the highest pressure moments here, seventh game of a semi-final here in Budapest, and these two continue to light it up.
They're trading blows here, forehand after forehand against each other. Locked inside this picturesque, now silent, showcase court. Who dares wins?
Dismissively, he breaks the deadlock there. All the threes. Got Wang here. Moves out in front in the seventh.
Shows how well, though, Ma Long served up to press, because Wang Chuqin could do that against that kind of serve over and over again. Anything too loose, even if it's a fraction, he can pounce on with that flick.
And again. Deja vu all over again.
Again, too loose. I mean, is that higher toss serve the right one now for Ma Long? The ball's coming in with more speed because it's a higher toss. If he wants to keep it tighter to the net, it'll be easier for him to do that with the medium toss. Maybe he needs to change that. I'd be surprised if we keep seeing a high toss now from Ma Long.
That to say that Ma Long had kept his time out in the bank, and he's cashed it in now here. Trailing by a couple. Of course, they turn round as well off the back of the timeout, so it's all going on. Said, you know, he's out there, he's still playing incredibly high level, of course, two in the world, playing the biggest events, he's won everything. Deep down, he relishes these situations. He's got a problem here to solve.
Charles Morigao waiting for the winner. It's an interesting topic, who you would rather play if you were Charles Morigao. Ma Long has actually beaten Voldner before, who has a comparable style to Charles. Shows how long Ma Long's been at the top. Bit of a trickster on the court as well. Look at that there, the fan and the crowd with a message. Got a few laughs on the replay.
Shake of the head from Ma Long. He was 8-5 down in the fifth in the deciding game to Lin Gaoyuan, and then lockdown. Really clutch serving from there, everything else. He's 4 adrift here in the seventh to Wang now.
Earth as he reached that backhand on the move and still played it down the line. That for me is the shot of the match in terms of difficulty level. Watch this. Didn't even hit the edge. Hit the white of the line. That is insane.
Is he peaking at just the right time here, Wang Chuqin? 3 points away. This is 3 points away, but he still feels so far away because of his teammate, as he calls him, at the other end of the table. know what Marlong is capable of, even in the most perilous situations.
What a match. At times it's felt like a marathon, at others it's felt like a sprint.
Again and again at Marlong there. Attack after attack.
You can see Wang Chuqin's eyes light up as he stepped around there and saw the open space. His dream shot became a reality in an instant, and it was too hot for Marlong to handle.
Loudest Cho similar of the night here. Wang Chuqin to greet a key moment. Key because he now has 5 match points. And he's finished him off. Wang Chuqin into the finals here at WTT Star Contender European Summer Series in Budapest. They'll be happy. And, well, this clash of generations going the way of the younger man. He beats Marlong, the greatest of all time. And he will go for the title against Truls Morgaard on Sunday here, prevailing in the full 7 games to edge out Marlong 11-5 in the decider. Really, really difficult for him, didn't it? I mean, he lost those second and third games, and again the fifth. He was behind, but he's shown, in addition to all his quality, a real resilience, Wang Chuqin, to prevail there in the end. And he was the stronger in the seventh.
Well, I mean, yeah, the Dragon Slade came through the last 5 setter. This time, no. 7 setter, Wang Chuqin, really, really brave, bold, and flamboyant in that final game. And from a youth standpoint, what a final we have for tomorrow.